A godless Wild West is no match for the fearsome Merritt Wever. If Merritt Wever isn't necessarily the first actress you tap for a Western, the Emmy winner is right there with you. I'm still wondering why they thought of me too, the born-and-bred New Yorker says of her role as Mary Agnes Maggie McNue, a leader in the matriarchy running the 1880s frontier town of La Belle, New Mexico, in Netflix's Godless, which begins streaming November 22. Having lost their husbands in a mining accident 2 years earlier, the women of La Belle aren't quite sure what to make of Mary Agnes, the mayor's widow. She's traded her corset and dresses for cowhand clothes, reclaimed her maiden name, Albert's dead. There's no reason for me to keep carrying his name about like a bucket of water. He's got a brother in Missouri for that, led negotiations with prospective mining executives, Mr., we're a whole lot fucking stronger than you think we are, and coupled up with prostitute-turned-schoolmarm Callie Dunne, Tess Frazer. I'm done with the notion that the bliss of me and my sisters is to be found in childbearing and caregiving, she tells her disapproving brother Bill, Scoot McNairy, the town sheriff, and one of its few remaining men. Wever candidly admits that Mary Agnes's toughness made her nervous at first, because the actress wasn't feeling especially strong or confident when she accepted the role. Her solution was to tap into that feeling and look for the ways in which her iconoclastic character was vulnerable or struggling, or the ways in which her armor was broken. Wever also leaned into the idea that the tragedy had liberated the women, opening up new opportunities for them to live and take up space a little differently. Which is why Mary Agnes is bent on achieving some economic independence and embracing her full sexuality. That interpretation suited Godless creator Scott Frank, best known for scripting Logan, the Wolverine, and Out of Sight. Surprisingly, the writer-director says that, when casting director Ellen Lewis suggested Wever for this role, which he says may be his favorite character ever, he wasn't familiar with her work as beloved Zoe Barco on Nurse Jackie, or, more recently, as trauma surgeon Denise Cloyd on The Walking Dead. But Frank did remember Weaver's brilliant and moving turn as Anna, a naive young woman caught up in an attorney's death in the George Clooney thriller Michael Clayton. Before their initial meeting, Frank heard that Wever was shy. But the moment the actress sat down, he felt instantly she was the woman he'd been writing. I suddenly saw Maggie as a woman for whom underneath all that bravado was someone very uncomfortable with herself, constantly walking away from every encounter feeling as if she'd blown it, even though she appeared tough as nails all through it. Merritt brought all of that. What Wever didn't bring to the New Mexico set, where she spent 3+ months, were any horseback riding or shooting skills. So along with the rest of the cast, she attended what her co-star Michelle Dockery, who plays twice-widowed single mom and town outcast Alice Fletcher, dubbed Cowboy Camp, learning to plausibly look like a fast-drawn and experienced equestrian. Though she didn't enjoy shooting a gun, Wever nevertheless felt a sense of accomplishment at having learned how to handle one. Much more enjoyable was working with Dockery, whom she found warm and really fun. Though the two women didn't have many scenes together, the show's main plot centers on Alice harboring Roy Good, Jack O'Connell, a defector from brutal outlaw Frank Griffin's, Jeff Daniels, gang. There's a pivotal shootout in which their characters are thrown together. I felt like I had the best job in the battle, to just hang out with Michelle on a roof for a couple of weeks, she says cheerfully. We were literally above the fray, watching everyone else battle it out. Wever avoids strife in her own life by staying off social media, noting that not all of her friends are there anyway. It's not like I've never gone and looked, but I don't feel like it's for me right now. She's also avoided the stress of driving by never getting her license. I think it would have been easier when I was younger and maybe a little more fearless or naive, although I was always neurotic. Now, I just know so much about what can go wrong, she says. What's certainly going right is a career in which Wever has worked